Cassandra and I met on match.com.
He offered to take me on a picnic and make fruit salad, and I thought that was a little creepy, so I blew him off. But then I thought maybe I hadn't been dating the right kind of guys, so maybe I should try a different kind of guy. So I gave him a shot.
Eventually, she did agree to see me. It was a long time coming.
I was supposed to go on a second date with a guy, a different guy, the day after I met Corry, and I canceled that date because I felt pretty good about meeting Corry.
I guess about a month passed, and we were still talking to each other, still tolerating each other.
Well, I remember when Corry asked me for permission, and that was nice, you know. I'm not sure it would have made a lot of difference.
I took a piece of paper and soaked it in tea or coffee and burnt the edges and rolled it up and put it into a bottle. And when we were at this convention in Atlantic City, I carried this bottle around with me in my pocket to all of the casinos all night long, and couldn't find the perfect moment to give it to her and ask her. And when we got back to the hotel, I had no choice but to do it there and say that I found it on the beach and made her read the poem that I had written in a quill feather pen. And the poem reads on the end, "Will you marry me?" So she said, of course, had no option but to say yes. And we left there, and I remember calling my friend Josh, and he said, "Ah, you beat me to it. I was planning on doing it next weekend." And Josh and Barb got married shortly after we did.
We were happy that Cass and Corry had met and that they had fallen in love. So we were really happy about that. And we were really appreciative of Corry having a family background, you know, a strong family background. So that meant a lot to us. So we were really happy about it. I mean, not every little thing, but in the big picture, we were very, very happy. So, and then the fun started.
The wedding, we started thinking of where to get married, and didn't take much thought.
We had owned our house on Cuca Lake for 5 years, and it was very nice to know that they liked this place as much as we did.
I have fond memories of Cass and Corry's wedding. It was a lovely location at the head of Lake Kukla.
Just really wanted to share the lake with everyone that we knew.
A beautiful setting. You can't beat being on the lake.
The sunsets, the positive energy that radiates from that body of water.
It was very exciting for us because we wanted to share the lake and how beautiful it is.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me, so deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I
think we needed a few more place card holders. So we were trying to find somebody that would have a blade to be able to cut some bamboo for the place card holders.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. So we ended up stopping randomly at a barn on the Westlake Road, and the gentleman ended up helping out by giving us a saw.
Yeah, we're lifelong friends now.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats, repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin. Sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Why not use your mentality? Step up, wake up to reality. Time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin. Yes, I've got you under my skin.
So we had a rental that had four different units in it. So we were able to have Dave and his brother and his family in one. We were in another one. My brother was and his family were in one, and my sister and her family were another. And we had all kind. It was like a...
It was great. Somebody else needs to get married for us to get together again. Yeah.
We had, it was almost like having a tailgate party all the time, because we had all kinds of games outside. Everybody had a good time. My sister brought a van full of flowers up, and all the flowers were made on site at the rental.
I did not help with the flowers at all. a lot of people did, though.
My sister and her husband were delivering the flowers to the church, and they got lost, and they couldn't find the church. And so they got there, like, just in the nick of time with the flowers. What else?
That happens a lot for them, I think, though.
It does. The day of the wedding, it was beautiful weather. Our niece Leah did Cass and the bridesmaid's hair.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Before, we are?
Yeah, that's what Corry said.
I thought Corry was kidding.
From behind?
Yes.
There you go.
Awesome.
Cool.
Cool.
It's just all open. I want you to come in tight around Cassandra.
Oh, just looking right at me. Perfect. Just like that.
Are they leaving?
Right at me, guys. Good.
Colin?
You're Colin?
Yeah.
Hey, good to meet you, man.
Look at this guy. He looks sharp. What's your name?
I'm Hans.
Hans?
Yeah.
Cool name, man.
Dance thing, you know, just mix it up, mix it up. So some guys over here, I don't want anybody behind them because I won't be able to see you, so step off to the sides.
Yeah, follow someone, you can just have hands in pockets, arms crossed, whatever. Just
guys look great, perfect.
Good, we're done. See you tomorrow. Let's go over here. Kaylin, great, great. You guys look good over here. Shannon, great. Tyler, good. All right, guys, looking right at me. Just kind of a serious look. You don't have to smile, just a straight look, okay? Even with the wind blowing, you guys look awesome. All right, guys, here's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna go for a walk. Just walking this way. You guys are holding hands, just nice and easy. Just walking towards me, okay? Go.
Yeah.
You're walking and talking. It's not video. The video's over there, so you can make fun of this guy talking or whatever.
Let out a little.
Just drop him next to Frank.
In my house, 11:30. Everybody tomorrow.
Yeah,
morning,
he said
11:30,
that.
11:30.
He forgot. He's like on the phone. Not number one. Brian calls Alex this morning. He's like, oh, I think 3:00. I'm like, no, not 3:00. I'm like, did you start at 1:00? It's like 15 minutes away. Like, he was like, oh, I didn't know.
Josh forgot his pants.
And that was an interesting thing. Yeah. Josh forgot to bring
his pants. I remember that too. So, because that sort of was a bigger deal than the bamboo.
Right.
Yeah, that he didn't have any pants.
So they ended up, nobody's shared this story, they ended up going to a dry cleaner, I believe, in Penn Yan, that happened to have a pair of pants in his size that he was able to use to wear in the wedding.
Right.
Oh,
lead pass, and Corry Bartley player. May this be a time of meeting, understanding, hope, and love for us all. This is the saddest and the gladdest of times, when sadness is sweet and gladness is sober. Something dies today and something is born. The past becomes past. The future reaches out. This is a time between times, a time within time, a moment that exists for its own sake and for the sake of what we do here. It is, in other words, a holy moment, a sacred moment, a transcendent time.
Who gives this woman to be married?
Her mother and I.
Go sit down. Okay. You can face each other. Good. We are here to celebrate. What we bring with us is mainly who we are and what we have been. Memories crowd about us at this moment. Memories of what was, of innocence tempered by experience, of relationships that made this relationship possible, of hopes grown, dashed, and rebuilt, of lives intertwined, of loved ones gone on before us. In these memories, we look for a pattern of life, a thread of love that has been developed, perhaps in spite of ourselves. We celebrate that love, that pattern of life, for it is the most that we humans can give and receive. It is a gift of God. It is what is shared by Cassandra and Corry and with their whole beings. Let us give thanks that this is their reality. Let us hear a reading now by Lauren.
The promises of marriage. Marriage is a promise of companionship, of having someone to share all of life's experiences. Marriage does not promise that there will not be any rough times, just the assurance that there will always be someone who cares and will help you through to better times. Marriage does not promise eternal romance, just eternal love and commitment. Marriage cannot prevent disappointments, disillusionment, or grief, but it can offer hope, acceptance, and comfort. Marriage can't protect you from making individual choices or shelter you from the world, but it will help to reassure you that there is someone by your side who truly cares. When the world hurts you and makes you feel vulnerable, marriage offers a promise that there will be someone waiting to listen, to console, to inspire. Marriage is the joining of two people who share the promise that only marriage can make, to share the sunshine and the shadows, and to experience a richer, more fulfilling life because of it.
Now we are at a special moment in the development when love of Corry and Cassandra, feeling incomplete alone, have declared that something special in them, something about the way that they are made, enables them to find more fulfillment together than they could have hoped to find apart. And having discovered this, they wish to sanctify this union, to give it unique meaning and significance by sharing it here in our presence before God. What lies ahead is not certain. It never is. Cassandra and Corry are human beings, and therefore the patterns of their growth and development are not wholly predictable. But they have reached a new time in their lives today, a time for tying a knot in the rope of days and saying, We will not slip backward from here. Now we are going forward. It is a time for taking vows, for facing the uncertainties of the things about which they are certain, namely that they love each other and that whatever the future brings, they will face it together. Won't you hand your flowers back? Okay. Corry, will you have this woman, Cassandra, to be your wife and be faithful to her alone? If so, say, I will.
I will.
And Cassandra, will you have this man, Corry, to be your husband and be faithful to him alone? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Okay. Let us hear another reading by Brandon.
If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all of mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
Thank you.
Corry and Cassandra will now repeat their vows.
In your eyes I have found my home. In your heart I have found my love. In your soul I have found my home.
You make me laugh, you let me cry, you are my breath, my every heartbeat. I am yours, you are mine. Of this we are certain. You are lodged in my heart, the small key is lost, you must stay there forever.
Corry, you are my inspiration and my soul's fire. You are the magic of my days. You help me laugh, you teach me love. You provide a safe place for me unlike I've ever known. You free me to sing my own song. You are more of an amazement to me each day I rediscover you. You are my greatest gift. I am yours. You are mine. Of this we are certain. You are lodged in my heart. The small key is lost. You must stay there forever.
Thank you. The vows which have been exchanged by Corry and Cassandra have been offered in our hearing, but words are fleeting and the sound of them is soon gone. Therefore, the wedding ring becomes an enduring symbol of the promises that have been made. May these wedding rings be a reminder to Cassandra and Corry of the vows they have shared today and a witness to all of the world of their commitment to each other in marriage. All right, why don't you put this on the fourth finger of her left hand. It's okay, it'll go over. There, okay. And repeat after me. As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
And my commitment to you throughout our lives.
And my commitment to you throughout our lives.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
This on the fourth finger of his left hand. And repeat after me. As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
And my commitment to you throughout our lives.
And my commitment to you throughout our lives.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Very good. Cassandra and Corry will now take flame from separate candles and join them as one. Okay, you can hold hands and stand there. Inasmuch as you, Corry, and you, Cassandra, have both come before God in this company, declaring your intentions to be married, speaking the vows of marriage, and exchanging rings as a token of the promises you have made, you are now husband and wife. Go into the world and fulfill your lives. Hold fast your ideals. Give to one another new experiences of joy, and may the love you hold for each other, now sealed in marriage, continue to grow. And may your life together be a source and inspiration for all those whose lives you touch. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Perfect setting, and the church there at the college certainly is spectacular, the chapel.
I thought it would be nice to capture a picture with
white doves. It's a symbol of love.
I thought it was crazy bringing that many birds, but whatever. A lot of people looked a little frightened.
Yeah, we got a couple really stunning pictures. Andres really pulled through on that.
He got some good pictures.
Just keep the birds coming and coming and coming. It was funny.
I'm happy that we scaled it back to 30 or 40, and I didn't follow through on my 120 that I had planned.
What a glorious day. Here we are at Keuka College, and there we have Keuka Chapel, where one Corry Bartley Flagel and one Cassandra Lee Powell have just gotten married.
All right, ready?
And here they are.
1, 2, 3. Max, right over here, bud. Perfect. Guys, looking excellent.
Looking great, guys.
Max is doing
looking
great.
Real good. Looking real good.
Keep blowing them.
Little family shot.
You're all free to go.
Except for parents.
Okay, parents and grandparents.
And there, in the background,
and the bubble machine
we have Keuka Lake, where the magic starts. Easy, folks. Easy, makes easy, beezy, weezy. How we doing?
We're doing real good. Doing real good.
Nice.
And a little later, we're going to do even better.
Yeah, just come in.
Oh, what an awesome family.
Such a glorious day.
Corry and Cassandra and I were coming back from Hunt Country Vineyards, and we stopped at Esperanza to have a look, and they really liked it.
I don't know that you could find a more, like a nicer view than from Esperanza up there at the mansion.
Having a church friend, Joe Benedict, come out and did a magnificent job playing for the cocktail hour. A live piano. He also played the organ at the ceremony. Live band in at the reception. All local wines.
First of all, we have the sister-in-law and brother of the bride, Margaret and Tyler Powell. Following them, we have the cousin of the bride and brother of the groom, Caitlin Powell and Noah. Skolnick.
Now the cousin of bride and the friend of the groom, Shannon Dillon and Brian Whitaker. Alright, these are friends of the bride and groom, Stephanie Brenner and Ryan McFarlane. Following them, sister-in-law and brother of the groom, Angie Flago and Alexander Flago. Now we have friend of the bride and brother of the groom, Caitlin Blakely and Colin Flago.
The surprise I had when I was asked to be part of the wedding party that was introduced to the reception. Carl was in the middle, and Ilse was on one side, and I was on his other arm. And when we walked in, everybody shouted and clapped, and it was just a real treat.
Everybody having a good time? I feel so many different emotions today watching you guys. I feel like what I've written doesn't even pertain to what has happened, what I've seen. But welcome everybody to the wonderful wedding of Mr. and Mrs. Corry Flago. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Colin. I'm Corry's oldest brother. I was up all night writing this, so I appreciate a great big round of applause after the last one. Ah, what an amazing day. It's just so beautiful here. You couldn't ask for more better. Great weather. I think we all need to say thanks to the great people that made this day possible. Cassandra's parents, Dave and Sharon. And also Corry's parents, who are also my parents. Cassandra, you look gorgeous today, radiant, absolutely beautiful. I think that I speak for every guy in the room when I say that today is a sad day, as a beautiful woman is.
taken off the market. And I'm sure that the girl in the room will agree with me when I say that today's just another day. But really, yes, meeting you has been the best thing to happen to Corry in his whole life. I mean, you're smart, you're beautiful, you're sincere. I could go on and on, but the bottom line is you have the incredible talent of tolerating Corry in his quarters. Corry, I gotta go to my notes here. Corry is an amazing guy. Let's give it up for Corry. He's hardworking, he's disciplined, he's in great shape, he's a leader, he's an entrepreneur. I can't read the rest of what these are on here. I wrote down some helpful advice from some great people. Wise man named Henny Youngman once said, "Some people ask the secret of our long marriage. We take time to eat out twice a week. A little candlelight, some dinner, some soft music, and dancing. She goes on Tuesdays, I go on Fridays." The great Colin Chapman said, "The secret to a great marriage is to not be home too much." And Woody Allen gave this advice: "In my house, I'm the boss. My wife is just the decision maker." This is a new beginning for both of you guys, and we're also honored to share it with you. Everyone here, your family, your friends, the staff. No, but really, everybody, please raise your glasses. I forgot to get them on. Remember this day always. Give thanks for it every morning. Keep your vows on your lips and in your hearts. Thank you. Carry your intentions of this celebration with you, and spend your days together in happiness.
Mad props to Colin for getting up there and putting on a stellar speech. It was unexpected, and he did a great job. He really wowed the crowd. I mean, everyone was laughing, everyone was crying. It was great.
I was surprised probably how good and like funny Colin's speech was.
That was great, Colin. Now the maid of honor has a toast.
Our friendship started in Girl Scouts, if you know us, and it's been everlasting ever since. She's like a sister to me. She's compassionate, smart, rational, easygoing, and of course she's beautiful, especially today. I just want to tell the story of how I met Corry and how Cassandra met Corry. Cassandra was single, looking for someone to get very serious with. She's ready at that point in her life. We were joking around about the idea of internet dating, and Cassandra's father chimed in from the other room and said, "I'll pay for a subscription for a month if you give it a shot." So at first we were kind of joking about it, but then she really got into it. And she went on some bad dates and some alright dates. And then there was this one guy. And I would periodically ask her about it, like check up on her, how's she doing? And she said, "There's this fish guy." He fish and asked for a living. Yes. But I'm not so sure about a date with him because he wanted to take her on a picnic for the first date, which, in any girl's eyes, would be very romantic. But when it came to Cassandra, she's like, "That's a little bit cheesy. I don't know. I don't know how I
like I said, where me and Cassandra began. So I feel like the cycle has completed itself. He's charming, motivated, witty, and more importantly, he can help her make decisions. But if you know Cassandra at all, sometimes she has trouble with that. I can honestly say I've never seen her so happy. The love radiates off of her and she just glows. She just smiles and has blossomed and she's just beautiful now. Not that she wasn't before, but he makes her a beautiful person. I'm so happy for both of you and I look forward to a wonderful future of memories.
I knew Kate would be thoughtful because she's like the most thoughtful person I know.
The blessing now which will be given by the father of the bride, David Powell.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, I'm so thankful for this time that these two young people can come together and fall in love and find each other and have a future that is before them, and that it's up to them. They got the world by the tail. I'm so thankful for the love that my daughter will receive from her new family. And we're thankful to have someone else that we can love. We're really pleased that they're going to be starting their new family and have the support of two great families and a lot of fun. And we ask, Lord, that you fill their lives with health, happiness, blessings, many children, and all the things that are in your plan for them. We also ask you to bless this food to our bodies, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen.
I jumped off the dock.
I can't jump off our dock.
It's a crazy operation.
Where else would you go?
Oh, no, that's the end. Which I left in somebody's van.
when it came time to decide what we were going to dance to, Frank sang some good songs, and I was very close to my grandmother, and she loved Frank Sinatra, and when we talked with her, it just came natural. I've got you under my skin, and we had fun with it.
We took dance lessons. I thought we were doing pretty good at the dance lessons, but my dress would have cost a lot of money to get it hemmed, and I didn't get it hemmed, and it was too long, and I kept tripping on it.
All right, now we need Dad. Dad and the bride. Father and the bride, come on up. Thank you.
Told me they did that at their wedding and it was funny, and I just thought of it, and I don't know, thought it'd be funnier with them with cake in their face instead of us, but I think they were confused.
It was a great party. It was a lot of fun, a lot of dancing. It certainly set the standard for weddings to come.
She's got a new look.
It was kind of cool that Corry and Cassandra danced to a Frank Sinatra song. Cassandra and her father danced to a Frank Sinatra song. And Noah sang a Frank Sinatra song.
Dedicated to them.
They lingered there to touch your hand and walk with me all summer long. We sang a song and it was so that golden sand. Two sweethearts and the summer moon. They were by and by. The world was new beneath the blue umbrella sky. Then softer than the piper man, one day called to you. And I lost you to the summer.
Practicing it or rehearsing it, he just sort of pulled it out and sang it, and so I think that was kind of funny. It seemed like he would have picked something else that was not Frank Sinatra, but I guess Frank Sinatra was the man of the hour, man of the day.
He had been singing in public for a couple of years, but we never saw him sing in public. He sang around the house, didn't like me to videotape him, or if I did, he didn't want to share it with anybody, so it was really nice to see him sing in front of a group of people, and it was great.
And Noah singing and just tearing up the dance floor, it was something else. Now, he wasn't alone. Everyone was tearing up the dance floor. Joe Benedict made that easy. Really, the live music and the atmosphere and the wine. There was a lot of wine being poured. There was a lot of dancing. It was a lot of fun. It was, having been to many, many weddings in the last, 5 years, here we are 5 years later, I have to say that next to maybe one other one, I think 95% of the people were out on the dance floor, were not in their seats, just enjoying the time and really, really having fun.
I also remember the Flegel men with their hats and instruments later on being real silly, and that was fun.
Kate always reminds me of our wedding, and when she'll never forget seeing all of the Flegel men on the dance floor doing a very similar dance move where they just bounce up and down.
The Flegel men gonna do a funky sound.
Is this only a small group?
No.
you do.
It's great to have family, you know, have everyone together for one last hurrah. You never really know when you're gonna see people again, and maybe you don't see them ever again. So it was nice to get everybody together. And it was quite a party. People dancing and got a little out of control.
It was also nice that they chose the date that they chose, which is only 3 days after our anniversary, the date that we got married, so that was a lucky day.
The single thing that sticks out most for me is having the privilege and, you know, the pleasure of walking my daughter up down the aisle in the church. And, you know, I was really thankful that I had that opportunity in my life. And it wasn't a hard thing to do, because I felt like she was going to have a very exciting and full life with Corry. And I think time has proven that out to be true. And they've definitely enhanced our lives, not just with their marriage, but with our grandchildren and stuff. So it's been really good.
The end.